Most trees reach for the sun. Then there's the weeping willow. Sure, its trunk grows upwards, but on the whole, these trees droop down, basically growing toward the ground. What, or who, are they weeping for? Hi, I'm Kate, and this is Minute Earth. First, not all willows weep. Hundreds of willow species exist worldwide, and most of them have a more standard, upward-reaching shape. Also, willows aren't the only trees that weep. Lots of trees, like the poplar, hemlock, maple, acacia, cherry, and peach, also have weepy varieties. The droopy demeanor of weepy trees, and actually the overall shape of all trees, stems from the same cause: hormones. Hormones, which are directed by a tree's genes, help a tree recognize which way is up, establish the angles of its branches, and determine how long and thick those branches get. But occasionally, a tree will have a genetic mutation that makes its hormones act in weird ways. Some of these mutations make a tree grow more upright, and others cause it to droop down toward the ground, a form we, poetically, call weeping. But let's go one level deeper. I mean, mutations happen all the time, but most die out. Why has weeping carried on in all sorts of different trees? It's possible that in certain situations, droopy branches benefit trees, maybe by maximizing the light that reaches a tree's leaves, or minimizing moisture loss, enabling weepers to survive and pass on their mutation. But I dug pretty deep into the research out there, and there's just no evidence of these kinds of benefits. Here's the thing, most weeping trees out there didn't get there on their own. Take the weeping hemlock, a tree for which we have a remarkably complete history. Most hemlocks have that standard upright shape, but in the 1850s, a farmer in New York discovered a single weeping one. People became obsessed with this tree's weird shape, and they took lots of small pieces from it, pieces that they used to grow their own weeping hemlocks. Weeping beech shares a similar story. Every weeping beech in America is said to be descended from a single shoot imported from Belgium in 1847. And the weeping willow, too, which likely originated as a rare variant of an upright willow species in China. These unusual willows were cultivated widely in Asia and were eventually traded via the Silk Road to Europe and beyond. We humans are the force that has spread weeping trees far and wide because we find beauty in them. And meaning, too. In different cultures, weeping trees symbolize resilience, femininity, hope, and grief. In other words, weeping trees have followed a path to success that a lot of other plants and animals have. They became common because we humans wanted them around. Willows, it seems, weep for us.